Now, hello students, come to the third part of the reflection. In the last part, we were studied about the rules for the image formation by the spherical mirror. Now, we come to the next point, that is the rule 4. And the rule 4 is, if a ray just directly falls on the pole, it follows laws of reflection. We understand by the image diagram. Let us suppose this is a concave mirror and this is a convex mirror. This is the pole, focus, center of curvature. Pole, focus, center of curvature. A ray is just directly fall on the pole. In this phenomenon, the principal axis behaves as a normal, and the angle formed in between the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. And the law of reflection says that the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. So that this, when the reflected ray takes place, then this angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection like this. And this follows the law of reflection. Similarly, in the convex mirror, the ray is falling on the pole directly. And this behaves as a normal principal axis. This is the angle of incidence, and this is what? Angle of reflection. So this is the rule 4. If a ray directly falls on the pole, it just follows the law of reflection. So we study about the 4 rules for the image formation by the spherical mirror. Now these four rules are applied to the image formation. We have to apply only 2 rules. There are 4 rules, but we have to apply only 2 rules, because there are 4 rules, because if one rule sometimes fails, then another rule uses. Therefore, we have 4 rules and we have to only apply 2 rules. And for the image formation, we have only 2 rays. So for now, come to the next topic, image formation by concave mirror. There are 2 mirrors. One is the concave mirror and one is the convex mirror. So we first study about the concave mirror. So image formation by concave mirror. And for the image formation, we have to know the position of the object. So let us suppose this is the concave mirror, this is the principal axis, pole, focus and center of curvature. One position is just an infinite. Second position is beyond the center of curvature. Third position, you put the object on the sea. Fourth position, you put the object in between C and F. Fifth position is you put the object on the focus. And the sixth position is in between pole and focus. So there are 6 positions of the object in the case of concave mirror. So now we start with the case first. When object is at where? Infinite. When the object is at infinite, so let us first draw the concave mirror. This is the principal axis, pole, focus and center of curvature. First position is what? When object at where? Object at infinite. So always you have to know that when the object is placed at the infinite, always coming the parallel rays. So we we have two parallel waves just coming from the infinite, and you know that from the first rule of the image formation, when the ray is just parallel to the principal axis, it passes from focus after deflection. It passes from focus after reflection. So the reflected ray meets at the focus point. So now we have to draw the three terms related to the image formation, that is the nature, position and size. Nature, position and size. So first we discuss about the nature. What is nature? Nature is just, you know that the when the ray is actually meet with each other, when the ray is actually meet with each other, you will not have to draw the reflected ray to meet with each other. So the image formation is what? Real and inverted. What? Real and inverted. When the rays actually meet after reflection, then the nature, you write it real and inverted. So here you see that the ray is actually meet with each other at the focus point, and where the rays meet is the formation of image takes place. So therefore the nature is what? Real and inverted. So what about the position? Position is at the focus. Position is at focus. What about the size? This is the highly divinized, because the image is formed at the principal axis. So this is your highly divinized or point size. So we have to write the three things about the image formation by the spherical mirror. First is the nature, second is the position, and third is the size. Now the second position of the object is when the object is beyond what? C. So second, object beyond C, center of curvature. So we have to first draw the Moncure mirror. Here is the principal axis, here is the pole, focus and center of curvature. The object placed beyond the center of curvature, that is the AB, is the object position. You have to apply only two rules for the formation of the image. So therefore, first rule is when the ray is parallel to the principal axis, you have to draw a ray parallel to the principal axis from the object. It passes from focus after reflection. It passes from focus after reflection. So you need two rays. So therefore you use two rules. Now the second rule is when the ray is coming from the focus, it gets parallel after reflection. So therefore this is the reflected ray. Here one is the reflected ray is here, and second reflected ray is the here, and they meet at this point, and where they meet, the formation of image takes place. So you have to draw a single perpendicular line to the principal axis, and this A dash B dash is the image. What? Image. This is the AB object, and A dash B dash is the image. You have to write three things about the image formation. First is the nature, and I told you that when the rays actually meet with each other, then the nature is real and inverted. Here the nature is real and inverted. What about the position? You see the position in the image diagram, that the position of the image is between the center of curvature and focus, in between C and F. What about the size? You see the object size is this and the image size is this. It means the image size is smaller than the object size. So therefore the size is what? Is smaller than object, or you just write a similar term, that is what? Divinized. What? Divinized. So we read about the two cases for the image formation. First is at the infinite, and second is at the beyond C. Now you have to learn about the next position of the object, that when the object is at C. So now we take the object at the center of curvature and apply the two rules for the image formation. So this is case third. Case third is nothing but when object is at center of curvature. So you have to draw the concave mirror. Here is the pole, focus and center of curvature. The focus is in just between the pole and the center of curvature. You have to put the object on the center of curvature. It is AB and you have to apply two rules. When the object plays at center of curvature, then you learn the rule that when the ray is just passed from the center of curvature, it reflects back on its own path, then it fails. So therefore, you have used two rules in between C. So therefore, when the object is at C, then first rule is what? When the ray is just parallel to principal axis, it reflects back after, it reflects from focus after reflection. When a ray is parallel to principal axis, it reflects from focus after reflection. Now, the second is when you have to pass the ray from the focus. The second rule applies. Then it passes from what? It passes parallel to the principal axis. Here it is the reflected ray. Here it is the reflected ray. They meet each other at this point. So therefore, the image formation takes place like this, and the image is what? A dash B dash. So when you put the object on the center of curvature, then the image formation also takes place on the center of curvature. You write three things, that is the nature, position and size. So therefore, first is the nature. Nature is what? The rays actually meet with each other. So therefore, the nature, I told you, is real and inverted. So nature is real and inverted. Position is where? Position is at C, and the size is what? You just see the size of the object is this, and the size of the image is this. They are the same size. So therefore, size is what? Same size of object. Or you just write that magnification is 1. Magnification 1 means the size of image and the size of object are what? Equal. So this is the third case where the object is at C. Now we come to the next case, that is the case 4. The case 4 is nothing but when the object is placed in between center of curvature and the focus. So when object is in between C and F, so you put the object in between C and F. So therefore, here is the concave mirror and here is the principal axis. This is pole, focus and center of curvature. Now the object is placed in between center of curvature and the focus. So this is the object position. You put the object in between center of curvature and the focus. Now you have to apply two rules. First, a ray is parallel to principal axis and passes from focus after reflection, and when the ray is coming from the focus, it gets parallel to the principal axis after reflection. So the reflected ray meets at this point. So therefore, you have to draw a single perpendicular line to the principal axis. The image is what? A dash B dash. So therefore, the nature, you have to write nature, position and what? And size. So nature is what? The rays actually meet with each other. So therefore, the rays is nothing but real and inverted. The image is what? Real and inverted. You see in the diagram, the image is inverted. So it means when you put the object just like this, the image formation is just like this. So therefore, the image is what? Inverted. What is the position? The position of image is what? Behind the C. So the position is where? Beyond C. And what about the size? You see, the object size is this and the image size is this. So you size is larger than the object size, therefore the size is not large. Large means the image size is larger than the object size. Okay, so you learn about the case 4. Now the similar 4 rules will apply on the 5th and 6th case. You can get this 5th and 6th case in our next part. Thank you.